gentlemen, Walter presents That Snow Lady, That's Darcelle 15 and Company.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Darcelle 15 and Company. I'm so glad you joined me this evening because I want to tell you we have with us tonight three entertainers. I mean, these are entertainers that spend from 9 till 2 in the morning behind a grand piano in a bar that maybe is a little too smoky. Maybe it's a little too loud in the back of the room. Maybe nobody pays any attention to them because they think they're background. These are the people that work piano bars. And I have, oh yes. I don't know, but we'll get into this. I'd like to introduce my first guest for this evening, a young lady that I met in New York. At Jan Waldron's in the Village, a Portland native, but I had to go to New York to meet her. She was working into a room that was so crowded, ladies and gentlemen, well, you couldn't see the piano, it was so crowded, because in New York City and on the West Coast, there's only one, Ava Williams.
Start spreading the news, I'm leaving this June to be a part of it. New York, New York, New York, New York. Those vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of it. New York, New York, New York. I want to wake up in my apartment I had for 44 years to find I'm queen of the 8th floor again, top of the heap. Those little town blues are melting away. I long to be a part of it in New York. If I can make it there, I can make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York. It's up to you, L.A. Portland, Oregon, I'm home to stay.
Ava Williams.
With a few trips on the side.
Thank you. Ava, a career that started when, Ava?
1931. Incidentally, I was born in Pendleton, Oregon.
Oh, right away she's going to correct me.
I graduated from the Grand High School. I had lived all my teen years from about 3 to 18 in the Grand.
And 31 years ago?
And my folks had a restaurant, so we had all the vaudeville people coming in when I was 12 years old, so I told my school chums that when I got older, I was going to take an ocean voyage, go to New York, and everything I told them, I did. And it's been a wonderful, wonderful life. That first picture you're about to show was in 1933 when I was 20 years old.
1933. We'll
in
get
Hollywood.
Right over here.
I was in Hollywood all the 30s. It was a wonderful time
that
to be in Hollywood.
Look at that.
Thank you. Thank you. Thin.
And you know, if you look real close, we resemble each other, don't you think?
Well, Ava? I think so,
yes.
Too. Great deal. Black wig?
No doubt. Ava, you have to, I mean, you like you worked in, Bahamas? You traveled the Caribbean?
Excuse the expression, Virgin Islands.
The Virgin Islands.
I worked the...
But I'm trying to think of Castro's. Where's that?
Oh, Havana.
Havana.
I didn't work there, but I was there during
Havana.
The war. I was there. It was
during
a wonderful time to be there. It was wonderful.
And
Havana was
New
beautiful.
York for years and years
I worked
and
in
years.
New York. I went to New York in 1939. I left there in 84.
And I worked all the top spots in New York. Met some wonderful people. I used to play for Judy Garland and Angela Lansbury. Wonderful people came in to see me. I have a faithful following for years and years.
When was this,
That was 1967, just a year before she died. She used to come in with Angela Lansbury and Liza. They came in the club I worked on, the 56th Street.
Tilt it back a little bit. There we go.
Incidentally, Joan Rivers was working down the street from me. She was just... She was
just
the upstairs
just
room,
starting her
not
career.
Too far.
No. Ava, do you mind if we tell them what birthday you just had?
I just had my 75th birthday, March 4th.
All right, enjoy. Seventy-five.
And still holding.
And holding?
Holding.
I wish we could get a shot of her high heels. She wears spike heels. There's nobody in this room.
Well, legs aren't
we
bad,
can.
Though.
There they are.
I
do a little burlesque for us.
I have. One time. I think I could do it again. I don't know. I walk pretty good.
But, you know...
I remember you at the Hoyt Hotel. You know, I've been working in Portland the last 30 years off and on. I used to come home and see my wonderful parents. My folks moved here in the 40s, and they had a radio show here for the Townsend Plan, and they, my mother and father have been singing for 70 years. I just lost them in 82. They were 90 and 96.
Longevity's right there.
And I hope I have the same longevity.
Oh, you will. Of course you'll be playing
until you're 100. They were wonderful. So I hope I have the same talent as long as I did.
You'll be playing the month of October at Lila's.
Month of October at 9th.
Lila's here
of October,
in town.
Friday and Saturday for
Friday
3 weeks.
Friday and Saturday night. I have another picture of Ava that we're dying to see, and I'll tilt it back this time.
Which one is that?
This is the one that looks exactly like me, not like me.
Like the fur?
Exactly.
With the fur. I had a lot of furs in the 40s.
A lot of furs
50s.
In the 40s. That beautiful. Can you see
that
it out there, ladies?
That was 1955 in New York.
And I have to tell you, because over the years we've traveled to New York a lot, and every time we went to New York and Ava was working there, we went to visit Ava.
Every time.
And every time.
Where else? Provincetown?
And my son and his young lady were engaged in Central Park, and afterwards we partied at the piano bar.
That's right.
And Ava was so sweet. It was about 2 o'clock in the morning. Now we're talking New York City, ladies and gentlemen.
4 o'clock.
Was it 4 o'clock?
Well,
Ava, I was putting you to bed. I know, but I was putting to bed earlier than that. And Ava said, I said, we'll take you home in a taxi. And Ava said, oh no, I'll just take the bus. 4 o'clock in the morning across town. Ava got on the bus in New York City. Not a problem for Ava Williams.
Well, that was a few years ago. I wouldn't do it now.
It was a couple years ago. Well, you don't even, yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, my dear heart, she's not going away. She's going to join me behind the piano. We bring our next
Thank
guest.
Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ava Williams. Wonderful. Stay here. Right over there, they're going to do... Would you welcome, please, from Hobos here in Old Town, a young man that... Well, I'm sure... Well, we'll find out how many years he's been in business, but the young man does a lot of jazz, writes a lot of his own things. Ava writes a lot of her own things, too. We didn't get into... We'll get into that in a minute, Ava.
That's all right.
Michael... Alan Harrison. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome, please. Michael Allen. Hello, Michael. Have a seat at our piano bar. This is the best we could do tonight, Michael, for a piano bar. Play a tune for us. Something you wrote, something you didn't write. Tell us about it, if you want to. Just put that over there.
How about something sentimental?
Sentimental.
Yes. Awesome. This is a piece I wrote for my mother. She turned 50 last summer. And I wrote this for her. She was living in Israel at the time, and I entitled it Ima Shali, which means Hebrew, for my mother.
All right.
How much time do we have, by the way?
Go. We'll let you know.
All right. Thank you.
beautiful. Okay, so you work in a crowded bar, and yes. you put this lovely, lovely music. Do you play yes. this often?
Yes.
When you work in a
yes.
bar?
Uh-huh.
Well, what do you do when someone yells, "Yellow Rose of Texas"?
Never heard of it.
I bet Ava knows how to answer that one. We'll talk later about that.
No, when I first started at Hobo's, I did lots of those songs, and that particular one might have been in a fake book or something. But now that I've been there for just about 2 years now, I do primarily my own music. The people know me. They know a lot of my own music, so they request lots of my songs.
What happens when you're playing something as beautiful as you just played, Michael, and the back of the room had an extra cocktail, and can you shut them out? Can you say, "I'm playing, this is my tune, I wrote it, I'm enjoying it," and can you just play with the noise going on? And
sure.
It's going to happen in a bar. We're not working.
Of course.
We're not working chapels.
Oh, it happens all the time. I, of course, enjoy it, and those who are listening are enjoying it.
And you can spot one person like, yeah.
Yeah, and if they're not listening, you know, that's fine. You have to expect that because it's a bar.
Yeah, we're not working in a chapel.
Right. You know, they're there to drink and talk, have a nice time. Maybe I'm reaching them on a subconscious level. Who knows?
But they're coming back. Yeah. That's the answer.
That's right.
They're coming back.
Yeah.
So there's something they're going to hear and see. Do you sing? I mean,
no,
do you sing when you play? I don't mean
no,
you should
I don't
do it
sing,
right now.
I don't sing when I play because I know my limitations as far as my voice, and I do very well when I sing a nice soft ballads that I write for myself that fits my voice. But if I sing in that particular setting, I'll start getting requests for things like Memory from Cats,
yes.
New York, so on and so forth. And my voice just isn't suited for that kind of thing, and so I don't sing there at all. But I sing for weddings and, you know. And,
yeah, and bar mitzvahs.
And you know, with my group and things
you know,
like that. Recordings.
I would love to be able to play piano. And I've told Ava this. I've told every piano player I've ever met, pianist ever that I've ever met in my entire life, I would love to play piano. Can't you just see Darcelle in a piano bar dressed up like this, just carrying on like trash? It would be wonderful. So that's my next life. I'll come back as a piano player. Princess. Michael, okay. You work with groups, though, and you write your own material. I know that you have a group. You have a group?
Well, I have two groups. I have my jazz trio, which I have primarily almost every weekend at Hobo's as well.
Oh.
So we're in a bar setting there, piano bar type setting. And then I have a new six-piece group.
Oh, big time.
It's called Inner Balance, and we play some of the larger clubs.
All
we're
right.
at Cafe Vivo this week, this Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, the 24th, 25th, 26th.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. So it's an exciting new group. We do mostly original music.
That's great.
And mostly original. Yeah. Ava, I have a question for Mike. How long have you been in business? I mean, how long have you been playing?
I've been playing since I was 7. That's when I started. But I've been in the business as far as professionally for about 3 years, coming close to 3 years.
About 3 years.
He has a little way to go to catch up with me.
Yeah.
A couple of years, don't you think? But it's the same thing, Ava. What do you do when somebody says Yellow Rose of Texas and you don't particularly feel like yellow, or any song that you
No, I'm not that way about
particularly
it.
Feel
I'm,
like?
I'm a performer. When somebody's nice enough to ask for a song, if I know it, I'll play it. If I don't know the words, I'll play it. I mean, I believe that that's one of your jobs. If you could do it,
yeah.
do it. You know?
Oh, yeah, but he had never heard of it.
Don't ignore
your
customers.
He's only been 3 years.
Don't ignore your customers. He's a baby yet. I've been in 55 years.
So it does work. And, Michael, play a little something, because I'll talk right over and introduce our next guest. I love it when you play. Go ahead, just do something wonderful. Nightly at Hobo. So do join Michael in Old Town. Thank you very much. Thank you. My next guest, ladies and gentlemen. My next guest, a young lady that I met, when the Hoyt Hotel was still functioning. The Hoyt Hotel. Joanna Burns worked there, sang their beautiful voice. She didn't play piano, but she might have played piano. We'll talk about how, what that happened. But then she was a feature vocalist at the Hoyt Hotel in Gracie Hansen's show. So, ladies and gentlemen, excuse me, Michael, you're going to join us back here, and Joanne's going to be there, okay? So, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. Michael, come right back here. Go get your microphone. Go get your microphone. You have your microphone on. Come around the back. Wonderful. We'll get it together. If I don't come in, nothing gets done. Ladies and gentlemen, Joanna Burns, ladies and gentlemen. Joanna Burns, currently at the Golden Crown. Hello.
I'm going to just start right in with one of my very own songs.
That's what I want to hear.
All right. Yeah. Ava has a request for Look Inside Yourself.
Great.
Sometimes it's hard to realize the treasures we have within. So we travel far and we travel wide till we're back to the start again. We test the waters from the seven oceans. We read every book we can. We keep digging for that very treasure that we're holding within our hands. Sometimes it's hard to see the forest for the trees. Sometimes it's hard to see just where that treasure can be. Just look inside yourself and you will see what you have to give, what you can be. 'Cause everyone upon this earth has been given a thing to do. Look inside yourself, find you. We get mesmerized by the deeds of others, astounded by the feats of men. Many famous people have passed this way, many more pass again. And for those who make the contribution of their love, for those who care, are not measured for what they do not have, but are measured by what they share. Sometimes it's hard to see the forest for the trees. Sometimes it's hard to see just where that treasure can be. Just look inside yourself and you will see what you have to give, what you can be. 'Cause everyone upon this earth has been given a thing to do. Look inside yourself.
Inside yourself. Was that was that like, let's do it? I mean, let's reflect a little on ourselves.
It's like, let's find out what's really in there, not what we think is in there or what someone else has said is in there, but what is really us.
How long ago did you write this?
About a year, I think. I wrote this about a year ago.
About a year ago?
Mm-hmm. I've been doing a lot of reflecting about what's inside there.
So I've written about 25 brand new songs in the last year, and they all have kind of the same theme about the great potential we all have, and
to know yourself,
the beauty we all have within, and we just need to bring that out. So I'm kind of on a campaign for bettering yourself.
Start with yourself.
Right, that's the first step.
Start with yourself.
That's right.
It's wonderful. How long have you been in the business?
16 years.
16 years.
Getting paid for it. Right.
We know that one.
Yeah.
We know that.
Actually, it's more like 20 years if you want to go back to the Hoyt Hotel, but that was kind of part-time, and then there was a little lull there where I got my piano bar act together. And then in 1971, I actually started for real in the piano bar business, and it's been 16 years.
And you're at the Golden Crown.
The Golden Crown restaurant and lounge every Friday and Saturday night.
We have to get it in because when the director goes to me, I start running crazy, and so we got to get it in because we want people to come and see you.
That's right.
How are you with your, what happens? You heard us ask, you heard the question I asked. What happens when someone is a little bit, shouldn't be driving, mm-hmm. probably shouldn't have that extra drink? What happens when they come to your piano bar, Joanna, and you say, and they ask for a song, and they don't really care about the song? What do you
Well,
do?
I usually do it if I know it. And sometimes I'll sing it, and afterwards they'll ask me to do it again like they didn't even hear it
that's
the first time.
That's the people I'm talking about. You got the right folks.
But what I usually do then is I remind them that I've already done it once, and the second time I charge. So then they put a little money in the tip jar. So, and then that kind of gets them interested then, and we kind of get them together. And I usually, when I have a difficult customer, I just kind of baby them, and pretty soon they come around to my way of thinking, and I can usually turn somebody around.
In comedy, we have a routine that is kind of our gear. I mean, it's mm-hmm. like we can shift into that and do the rest of the show.
Mm-hmm.
Do piano bar people have the same thing? Do you have where you can shift into this gear? You can't five nights a week. You don't feel wonderful every night of the week.
No.
You don't feel like entertaining every night of the week.
What you do is you go ahead and feel as lousy as you want to feel until you walk into that door.
That's right.
And then you become somebody else. Well, you're still you, but you become the performer,
exactly.
The actress, the singer, the musician, and you do the best thing you can do. You do the best you can do for those people.
Do you echo that, Ava?
I certainly do.
No matter what you feel, how you feel, you're right.
You leave your own feelings at home.
Nobody out there in our audience.
They don't want to know your troubles.
They don't want to know. They want you to know their troubles.
They came in to get rid of their
troubles.
That's right.
Ladies and gentlemen, this has been... Well, this has been absolutely wonderful talking to you. Now we're going to talk to everybody. Get real close because I want to know some more details about...
Right.
I've got to know about the Portland piano bar business. How is it?
It's very sad.
Very sad.
How many places do we have?
Three, maybe. Four.
Yeah.
Four or five.
Maybe four piano bars.
Yeah. Used to be 30.
What do you think that all these bars have done with their pianos? Pushed them in the back room?
Well, truthfully, I could say with a couple, I think they're putting young people in that are very inexperienced, and they're hiring things that do not match the room. And
that's true.
Really, they take in groups, put in groups, right? The Portland Motor Inn was a great piano bar. I worked there years ago. You know, Betty Whiting was there. She was just at a show. And it was a wonderful piano bar, and all of a sudden they put in groups up there and it just killed the room. And I don't understand. They had 30 piano bars here
I think I found when I was going around and first looking for jobs and whatnot that the owners or the managers of the establishments didn't have the right appreciation for that good music and that there's a great appreciation for that music out there.
See, we have millions of people over 40. Because we're all living longer, right? None of us know about that because we're too young. But
oh, I do.
Right. Well, just a little
You're
bit.
You're the only
just
one that admitted it, though, Ava.
So you have these young managers, these young owners, and they don't realize that there are that many people out there that they want to hear this older music, the 30s and the 40s, and the Broadway shows and the original music.
All
is
right.
that right?
Well, the other thing they don't realize is that the young people appreciate that music as
they
well.
They do.
There's yes.
A lot of people
absolutely.
A lot of the young kids come in and ask for the 30s and 40s.
Well, the cycle has come around again to where the young people think that that stuff is brand new. So it might be that we're going to start a new era
around,
here.
Turning around.
I hope so. And see, all club owners, this is the message. This is what we're doing this for, mm-hmm. is so that we can let people know that they don't have to go to 7-Eleven and
right.
rent a 99-cent video and stay home.
Yeah.
There are live people that are willing, able, mm-hmm. and more than capable
right.
of entertaining them for hours in all sorts of settings, in wonderful clubs, in supper clubs. It's got to keep going. You know,
yes.
I'd like personally Old Town to be full of mm-hmm. entertainment. I'd like everybody in the world to have to come to Old Town
yeah.
for entertainment. I would be so excited to have, because there's in the entertainment field, there's no such thing as competition. No such thing. If they come to see Darcelle, they're going to walk over and see you.
Right.
They're going to go see you.
Mm-hmm.
It's the most exciting thing in the world for me to go to a city like New York, where every other block there's an open mic, there's a piano bar, there's a jazz group.
There's something for everyone.
You don't even have to go inside sometimes. You can walk down in mm-hmm. the village and hear these things. Portland has the potential. We have the potential to do it.
Great city.
Well, we need all of you people to come and support what happens in the clubs. When you see
That's
somebody
right.
you like at a bar or at a in a piano room. Does that sound better than bar?
It doesn't matter. It's my father calls it a saloon.
A saloon.
He
I like that too.
He says I work in saloons.
I don't think. Yeah, I think maybe club owners should be dusting off their pianos or maybe getting the beer kegs out of them and moving them out on the floor where they belong. Again.
Well, there has been talk about some of these club owners have been asking me about piano bars now. They're thinking they might want to try that again. The only problem is they're going back 20 years on what they want to pay you.
That's right.
Oh, ho,
that's right.
Yes.
Right.
Like your wages for this evening.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Right.
But Joanna, I know, and I probably, yes, probably that's what they're doing. They're going
mm-hmm.
back. It's like we're starting new, so let's start mm-hmm. Where you started 20 years ago.
Let's go back below minimum wage, right. So what we need to do is raise that consciousness and let them know that we are worth something. Particularly Ava and I, we're seasoned. We've been around for a while. And Michael, it won't be long for you.
You've got 27 more years to go, and then you can be seized. No, I'm sorry,
Joanna. You know what I mean, though.
And, exactly.
So if anyone should get paid at least something that they're worth, those that have been hanging
in
there.
We have a following. We bring
we do
people
have
in.
A following.
And a following,
we
is,
have
what
a following.
Is where it's at. Yeah.
We keep a mailing list.
Every performer.
We work for a place.
Every piano mm-hmm. performer, or every piano bar performer that I know, they have a mailing list. They mail things out. They're not afraid to spend a couple of dollars
right.
for postage.
That's right.
It's more than a couple.
To let people know what's, I know, it's horrible. It can be horrible.
Yes.
And you have an album.
Oh, I have many. Many.
Ava has two albums.
Three
albums. You have an album yet?
I have a cassette tape I did 2 years ago, and I have a new album that came out this year.
Very good.
And they're always where you are. You have them with you?
Right.
Okay. This has been probably one of my best segments, ladies and gentlemen. I am so excited about piano bars. I love them personally. I love sitting at them. Ladies and gentlemen, my guests, Joanna Burns, Michael Allen, and Ava Williams. Three wonderful people. Go and see them and put a dollar in their tip jar.